lightbulb moments are my favorite thing in the world. Those aha moments. I love creating those. And I have quite literally a lightbulb moment for you to share. So here's a little chatbot that I built. It's called Homey. It's for home automation stuff. I dig that stuff. This here is what's known as a Govi light. It's from the company named Govi, and it has an API. I love it. The only problem is that the API takes RGB values. And I made an API and I hosted it on Workers, but really what I wanted to do is I wanted to be able to just say something like this. I wanted to say, make it red. And so with the ability of function calling, I can now do that. I can make things red just by using the word red, which is awesome. And I want to show you how I did it and how you can do it too. You don't have to turn on the red light, Roxanne. That's a good joke, right? All right, so here we go. So I'm inside my code. Again, the Govi stuff is coming from my environment variables. Let's make this go down a little bit here. I'm using Hono, which is incredible. If you haven't used Hono yet, it is time for you to use Hono. Let's check out the API first before we even get into this. So this is what the API looks like. I wrapped it. So this API slash light, right? And I've got three values here. I've got red, green, and blue. If you haven't played with this before, with this kind of color thing, this is how much red and how much green and how much blue. And you do it in between for 0 to 255. So it's just another way of saying things. So like this should be all green, right? All green, no red, no blue. And if I send this, we should come back and we should see that it turned green. So it does. Awesome. The way that this is working is with this change light color function, but before I even get to this function, so this is a function that I'm using inside of my API call, right? I just wrapped that. I made a post here, right? This is my Hono. I did a post to API light, and I pulled out the JSON, and from there, I'm going to pass in my environment variable, because that has what's coming in through my environment. It has bindings, it has any sort of variables or environment variables, really nice little package that comes through, that comes with your worker, right? And I'm going to pass this payload that has a R, G, and B. That was this payload right here. This is that JSON, right? So that's that payload that we're talking about. With that, I'm calling this change light color function. And this change light color function, I'm going to go ahead and make sure that the environment has this thing called a Govi API key. And if it doesn't, I don't want it to blow up on you. I want you to be able to run this too. So there's a repo that's here for you to be able to play with as well. So I'm going to set it to I'm a little teapot, which is the HTTP status code 418. I like to use this on any time there's an IoT device that it can't find. I like to use I'm a little teapot because I think that's fun. That's a fun little part of the internet. All right, I pass in the Govi API key. This is what their thing looks like, devices control. And I have these things set in my Wrangler as well. So I've got these variables, and then this is a secret that I've added here. And then I set the status code, and I'm just going to return back a little JavaScript object here, basically, right? That's what I'm going to return back. That's what my function does currently. I built this chat app, right? You've probably seen one of these before where I've got this endpoint, and I'm going to get back the JSON. I'm going to get that payload. I'm going to pull off the messages, right? So every single time, the way that I'm going to maintain state is I'm going to maintain it locally on the client. I'm going to just push that through every single time. I'm going to make sure that I've just taken a look at what's there, these submitted messages. And then I'm going to unshift. If you haven't done that before, that's how you stick something in the beginning. I always want to put in the system message at the start of this because I don't want the user tweaking it on the client side. I always want a system message there that I set. And this is, you are a home automation assistant named Homey. You will listen to the user's conversation and do your best to configure the home to match the conversation. So whatever the user's saying. And now here's the really cool part. So this is how we do tool calling or function calling, if you will. We build this array called tools, and I've named switch light color, and I put a very descriptive thing here about what it can do, because what's going to happen is the LLM is going to look at the tools that are available to it, and it's going to read the descriptions of what are available. So this description is important, right? So it changes the light color and changing the mood of the room. That's what that's important for. And then I passed in this is a JSON schema here for functions. You put in the parameters that you need here. So here you can see I have the RGB, and you can see that I have number. And then very specifically, I said the red value of the RGB of the color between 0 and 255. Now, if you remember, when I said make it red, it went and did that. It made it red. And so it has that concept, right? It has that concept of what this is. So if I said red, it knew that it needed to be 255.0.0. But it did that because these were described as being the RGB color, and I told it between 0 and 255. And then I said, of course, that these are all required, right? You need to do all three of those. In order to call this function, that's what you need to do. The way that this works, and this is awesome. So this is, I'm using a model here from our friends over at News Research, and it's called Hermes 2 Pro, which supports function calling. So function calling is super powerful. It is here now. you can do this and you can add any one of those tools that you want to call. And let me show you how that works. I put those tools in, right? I passed the tools in as a new parameter to my workers AI call. I passed in tools. And what's going to happen is the result that comes back, right? The result that comes back from this is going to have an object called tool calls. And inside of that, it's an array. It's an array, and each one of those, I'm going to call them here tool calls. They have a thing called name, so dot name, right? So in that list of things that come back. In this case, I only have one function, but I'm just being careful. And also, I'm probably going to build more in here, right? I'm going to add more. So I started with this. I started with a little switch case. So switch, if it's this name, I'm going to do this. I'm going to get the function response. I'm going to go call that same function. I'm going to pass in the environment, right? Because that's where all my variables were at. And then I have access to this thing called toolcall.arguments, and it's an object that comes across, and we'll take a look at what that looks like here in a second, that comes across, and I'm going to pass in the R, I'm going to pass in the G, and I'm going to pass in the B. Now, that's a little bit verbose, but I wanted you to see what that looks like. So I have the arguments, it's this named array, and that named array matches this. It matches this schema that I said. So I have done that. I'm going to push onto my messages stack a new role of a thing called tool. I'm going to pass the name of it, and I'm going to stringify what came back from that function response. And then I'm going to, again, pass that back to a model. And the reason why I'm passing that back to the model is because I want it to say, it did the function, and here's the output of the function, and it should respond with, oh, I did something from it, or if there was an error or anything like that. So it's going to use the output of your function to then go back into the message so that you can do more large language model stuff that we all know and love. So I'm going to print out the response. And if just in case there's not a response there, I'm going to go ahead, or in case there is a response there, I'm going to add in an assistant message. And I'm going to loop it just in case there's multiple, there shouldn't be multiple ones there. But that's, you can imagine you put multiple tools in there. Oh, and I need to call two tools, and it goes and it calls multiple tools. Like maybe I wanted to set my room to party mode, and it turns on my disco light, and it turns on my stereo through different functions, right? That I can do there. And I could say, change the music to this or this, whatever. Whatever I wanted to do in my little Homey app here, I could add these additional functions to go, right? So we're going to go through. If it doesn't, it defaults out. I'm going to get the final message, and then I'm going to do this cdotmessage.json. So that's it running. And all I need to do to get that up and running is, let's just get it going. We'll do npm run dev. And let me show you. Let's walk through this really quick. So I'll clear this here. I'm going to say, make the room the color of the ocean. Now, this is something that is pretty cool, right? Because the large language model knows what colors are right there. It could deduce that. And then it's going to go and it's going to find out what the color of the ocean is. And that's a pretty good, delicious looking ocean there. And it set it to RGB 155255200. Now, I also made it so it changed the light here. And you'll see that this light's picking up a little bit better than it is on my camera here. But that's a great looking water. I believe that's great looking water. You can do all sorts of random stuff in here too, but it's the power of the large language model. So now I've got this API that's wrapped in English on the front, it's getting a result back. And look, it says Homey has changed the light colorism of the ocean. It is now illuminated with a light blue hue. So not only that, it also knew what the thing was that came back. It knew what the color was and how to explain that. That is pretty cool, right? And definitely a light bulb moment, right? I hope that's a light bulb moment. I hope that you see that you could put English in front of any API that's out there. You could build any tool, put English in front of it, and put something back in. And the tool call, again, is really just adding it to adding a very well-described object to this thing called tools that you pass into these models, the ones that are enabled for function calling. And right now, this news research one is available. So you can go grab this code. It's in the comments. And I would love to hear what you think doing. And I'd also like to see what colors can you create. One of my favorites that I've done so far is you could do emotions, right? Make it the color of joy in the morning. I don't know. Does that work? Let's see what happens. So just play with it. Come and play and see what happens. I think it's probably going to do a sunset. That's what I would love. I would love the... Oh, it did a sunset. Look at the sunset. And there we go. Beautiful. I cannot wait to see what tools you bring into your LLM world to wrap with English. Let me know.